a reminder, folks, make sure you're looking after your kids. Pretty easy to get lost out here. We've got 5,300 competitors and 45,000 spectators. I might have just made that up. I did too, didn't I? You just saw some of the faces. No way! We do have lots and lots of people here today. We want to make sure that we don't get mixed up and take the wrong kid home. That's happened to me a couple of times. Not really. Watch your kids, guys, because there's lots of people here. We do have water features around here. Always a danger. So watch out for your kids. Don't get any lost. Don't get them mixed up. A safety tip from Mud Hero. big old mud pit. And we're speaking to a couple that are representing his gym. Who am I here with?
Stockholm.
Rebecca.
And Connor.
All right, tell me about your gym. What are you doing here? You're covered in muck. You've obviously just finished. What's the story behind your competition here today?
We're just looking for a good time.
We just heard of it and we thought you would try.
What gym are you guys from?
We're not from a gym.
And you're not from a gym? Oh, I thought you guys were representing some gym or something. All right, you've obviously got some story. This is your boyfriend. How did you meet? Tell us all the dirty secrets.
We met at school.
Where do you guys go to school? And what was it about him that you attracted to? Is it because of his hygiene?
Yeah, I guess.
He's a pretty good looking guy when he's all covered in muck, eh? Now what about your girlfriend? You ever see her like this? You know, dirty?
Oh, you know it.
There you have it. Wow, it's right there. I don't even know what to say, but this will probably be the last time you ever see her, son, so. Now as the father of this young lady, tell us about your daughter, and did you ever expect to see her this filthy and with such a dirty man?
No, but I think they've developed some dirty habits today.
You are not kidding, and we've all got some dirty, filthy habits here at Mud Hero. That's how it happens, and that's how it starts. So, do you approve of this relationship, Dad, or is this the end of it right here?
There are a couple of good kids, but I think they should go around one more time.
One more time. And for goodness sakes, I think they should probably have a shower separately. Yeah, good call. So, any words of wisdom? Were they training at home? How did they work out and come up with a fitness regime to compete here today at Mud Hero?
Lots of chocolate milk on the treadmill and lots of dirty swimming, I guess.
Sweet. Now, who paid for all that, Dad?
Yeah.
Exactly. Don't you forget it. I'm here with Len, and I was calling his name out, I think, when they were running through that mud pit. So Len looks like a bronze Adonis. He just stepped off the front cover of some fitness magazine, and I'm sure that's probably what drew him close to me with my milk bag form. Len, tell us a little bit about your boot camp and all this stuff, and what brings you to Mud Hero today. First of all, let's hear about your boot camp.
Well, it's been one boot camp. We run out of Etobicoke, Islington, and Bloor, out of my fitness center. It's Fit One Optimal Performance Center, where we train people of all ages, all fitness levels, and we get them fit metabolically, get them healthy.
Sweet, and who have you got out here with you today?
I have one of my boot campers, Leah Cook, and my business consultant, Linda Aylesworth.
All right, they came out with you today. Did you all just compete in Mud Hero?
Yeah, we did. Actually, I got a few of my other clients that are over there washing off the mud. So we got them all through.
Sweet, that's excellent. So what if I wanted to get a hold of you and I said, you know what, I live out that way and I'm looking for a boot camp. How do I get a hold of you?
Well, you can visit www.fitonebootcamp.com with the number one, Fit One.
So that's www.fitone. Beautiful. That's how I get a hold of you. Now, what can I expect if I went to your boot camp? What would happen the first day or night that I show up there? I don't even know.
What would happen is you would come in, you would sit down, you would go over your goals, do a fitness assessment, and basically we'll tell you what it takes to get from where you are to where you want to need to be.
Beautiful. And is this in a sort of a studio, or is this done from a home? Where am I going?
It's a 2,000 square foot facility that is basically made for large group personal training. So we call it boot camp, but it's large group personal training.
Oh, perfect. Okay, so I'm always going to show up in a group, and we're going to do some cool stuff together.
Amazing stuff. We utilize all sorts of equipment. We do medicine ball suspension training. We have kettlebell training, paddle ropes, tire pushers, power sleds. We got everything that we need.
Well, that's cool. Well, there you heard it from Len's boot camp. And Len, how do I get a hold of you one more time?
Well, you can visit www.fitonebootcamp.com in Etobicoke. And if you guys want to come in, I'll give you 2 weeks free of boot camp on me.
Holy doodle, you heard it right from the man Len there. 2 weeks for free over at boot camp. And just because you said that 2 weeks for free, you know you want to hear that one more time. Hey, Len, we aren't coming in for free. giving away, and I'll tell you, that's pretty awesome there. Thank you very much, Len, and the rest of his team here for showing up and competing here at Mighty Hero.
What happened to this guy, man? You really look, you only have one shoe, man. What happened?
happened to you?
I don't know. I can't even feel my left foot, so I took my shoe off.
You're a mess. And even were those white socks when you started out?
Absolutely. Oh, yeah.
That's the best. Oh, is this the kids that showed up that you were calling? Beautiful. Hey, where are you guys all from?
Oakville.
Oakville. Is everybody here from Oakville? Woo! I take that as a yes. How come this young lady didn't even go through the course from the neck up?
You know, just took it easy a little bit, you know. It's all good, though.
Man, were you like wearing a hairnet when you went through this? Like, you didn't get any mud in your head. How do you explain this?
I was just very late.
I mean, really, were you in a plastic bubble or something? She's still got the makeup habit in there. The hair's all done. Holy doodle, what the heck? What do you have to say about this?
Absolutely nothing. I'm done with it.
I'm just done with it. Exactly. That's where we sort out a lot of our family problems, right here at Mud Hero. Good stuff. What was the best part of the course?
Probably the mud slide.
What was the worst part of the course?
Waiting for people to get over walls.
Sweet. Now, how did you find just getting up that hill to the finish to get your medal?
It took 3 weeks on this damn hill.
This morning, but this afternoon, not so much. All right, guys, roll, Phil. Have a wonderful, fun film. Enjoy the day. I'm here with birthday girl Nancy, and she's assembled a fine-looking team here that was going to make their way to the lake and get cleaned up, but I stopped them. I intercepted them before they made it to the lake. Nancy, tell us about your team. Sensation when you return?
Yeah, we'll be in the Chronicle for sure.
Nancy, tell us, what are the rest of your birthday treats after this? Do you have any other plans for the rest of your birthday?
I don't know. I think I better clean up.
Get cleaned up, and then what?
Partay!
Well, interrupt that. And this thing has very muddy ears. Hey, maybe a Q-tip. All right. Have a good one. Take care. Wow, Nancy's birthday. She's loving it out here. She's heading off to get cleaned up and then go for a delicious beverage so she can have a happy birthday. All right, I'm here with Kim on the sidelines, and clearly a bit of a pink tie-dye team. Kim, tell me about your team.
We're from Burlington, and we're missing two people. They're coming right now. We rock!
Beautiful.
Go, Susie and Sam!
We're waiting with beers!
Susie and Sam, apparently your whole team is out here waiting for you with beers. And can you see Susie and Sam, or no?
No, we know.
Susie and Sam, if you're out there, the rest of your team is waiting to go for beers, apparently, so get your Botox in here. Kim, so you're all from Burlington. You guys, are you related? Are you from work? Are you just brought together by your evil forces?
Soul sisters!
Wow, soul sisters. Isn't that, what is that? I don't even know what that means. So what?
Sure. I don't really know what it means, but it sounds good.
Kim, you should drink lots of water and get that taken care of. You don't even know what the heck's going on right now. So you all assemble from Burlington. When did you come up with this plan to compete here at Mud Hero?
About 3 weeks ago.
Only 3 weeks ago?
We're in practice for a tough letter.
Oh, we can't even say. You know, that's a dirty word around here, Kim. I spit on that. I can't even endorse that sort of behavior.
Oh, we do them all.
Oh, okay. This is the beginning. This is the end, and everything else is out. There you go. Kim has come back to her senses. We gave her some water. She knows who she is, but the coolest thing. Did you start out incredible and just go downhill from there? What happened?
Yeah, we started out incredible probably 20 years ago.
Sweet. Hey, I've been there, but that was 50 years ago. Where are you guys from?
Burlington!
Hey, another Burlington crew. I was just talking to a crew down there from Burlington. They rock, we rock, because I'm from Burlington too. Are you guys all from abroad, related or work or school? What's the story?
She's awesome because, well, number one, she's beautiful. And number two, she's inspirational. She just excuses the way that she kicks your ass and you don't need a water to.
Wow, that's unbelievable. All right, so beautiful coach, tell me a little bit about your coaching. How did you assemble this incredible team?
First of all, I'm so proud of all my team. They're wonderful. Without them, I am nothing. They beat me up. They're wonderful. And they are the reason why I wake up every morning.
Did you assemble this whole team for this event? I guess the guys were saying you do a lot of these. That's kind of cool. How do you keep the group together? How do you keep them inspired?
We train together. We train together like a family. And then the family who trains together stick together. This is not our first, nor our second. Every time we're going to come for every challenge. This is our third one so far. We come to the top level and we did the obstacle course. This is the My Hero. Oh, my things.
Special events like this. So good times. Also want to thank all our volunteers here. Also want to thank the Toronto Region Conservation Authority. Not to mention Kevin Jones and his safety team.
Right.
just fine with that. Kramer, she did a good job subbing for Mr. Kramer on a Saturday afternoon. Be back next time. I'm not at the time on the two years with your mayor and your vote.
Come on, girl,
sidelines here, and I guess our spectators are waiting for Erica to come in. Erica just went in, and tell us a little bit about Erica.
Erica's her son's girlfriend.
Tell us a little bit about Erica.
This is our second race like this. We're pretty well.
That's not a lot. How well do you know Erica?
Fairly well, I think.
All right, how did she do out there in the course? Do you know?
She did pretty good.
How come you ran ahead of her and left her? To be answering for that one. So Erica, your boyfriend's down here, and he's waiting to give you a big hug and say how great you did, how proud he is of you out here competing and finishing the 2013 Mud Hero. Tell us about your team. They're shy. They're shy. That's why they're covered up like that. They're Ninja Turtles. Where are you shy guys from?
Niagara or St. Catharines.
You're not even sure if it's Niagara or St. Catharines. They're from Welland. They're from... Oh, you're from... Oh, my God. This has all been so confusing now. Who are these guys? Who are you with you today?
Manuela, Mike, Angela.
All right. Well, at least you know those names. Did he at least get the right names?
Yeah, he got the right names.
All right. How did you guys get together? Photos of his friends there from Oakville.